Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we are going to see how to make a very very tasty snack which you can use at tea time or also as a travel snack. That is a whole wheat methi khakra. And I have with me Ruby. All of you on my channel are familiar with her. She is quite popular for her dahi vada recipe. And more than a neighbor, she is like a daughter to us. She has so kindly agreed to show us how to make this recipe, and over to the expert now.
Hi, I'm Ruby, and today I'm going to show you how to make whole wheat methi khakra. Now we have taken 2 cups of whole wheat atta, and next we'll add chopped fenugreek leaves, which is also known as methi.
So we have taken 1 large bunch of this methi leaves, no, Ruby?
Yes. And
this green chilies, how many will it require? 3? Okay. So we are going to chop it, or how do you want to
use it? We'll make a paste of green chilies and then we'll add it to the flour.
Okay. So we'll just make a paste.
We have grounded 3 chilies into the paste without adding water. Now we'll add this paste in the bowl. Next we'll add 2 spoons of sesame seeds.
This is known as a til, no?
Yeah.
White til.
Next we'll add salt to taste. ¼ teaspoon of turmeric powder. And chili powder. Next we'll add little oil.
About 2 spoons?
Yeah, it would be about 2 spoons.
Okay.
And we'll take little water and we'll knead the dough. It should be in semi-soft consistency.
I think we can make this in more flavors also, maybe.
Yes, we can make into a pavaji flavor. We can add pavaji masala to it. Okay. And pani puri flavor.
Oh wow, that's so nice.
Pani puri masala to it. And this way you can make many flavors.
Okay. But I think methi gives a really authentic flavor to
this.
Yes,
and methi is also rich in iron, so it is good for health as well. Even sesame seeds also is rich in iron.
Yes.
I've mixed all the ingredients and made it into a smooth dough, and it should be semi-soft, in the sense it should be like puri dough. Now we'll let it rest for 15-20 minutes.
It is half an hour now. Are we ready to make it now, Ruby?
Yes, it's ready now. Now we'll make medium-sized balls.
Okay.
So we can make it either on the tawa.
Yes, we can. First we'll make chapatis, and then we'll make the khakra in the roti maker. And people who do not have roti maker can also make it on tawa.
So
I'll show you both the ways. Now we'll roll the balls into a circle shape. Make very thin rotis, so that the khakras would be crispy. Add little flour so that the chapati doesn't stick to the base. Thank you. Okay, those who cannot make a perfect circle or round shape rotis can use
any lid,
any sharp lid to cut it into perfect round shape.
So they need to look as if it's not similar to the one which you buy in the shops.
Yeah, you get a perfect circle.
Okay. I kept a tawa for heating. Now she is going to just roast these chapatis. But any oil you require, Ruby?
No, we don't require any oil.
Okay, only on dry heat.
Yes.
I just flipped it over after a few seconds, and now again turning it over to the other side. It need not cook completely. We are just going to about half cook it and remove and keep ready.
Half cooked, and we can remove it now.
Likewise, we can make with the remaining dough also. Make them into lemon sized balls, and as she said, roll them out very thin. Only then your crust will be nice and crispy. Then turn it on both sides on the tawa and remove it when half cooked.
The second one is also ready. Now we'll remove it from tawa and keep it aside.
Now there are two ways of making this. If you are making it on a tawa, you can just continue by keeping that roti on the tawa itself and then press it with a cloth along the edges. Press it well. And then you'll have to flip it over and yes, press it on the other side also. And the flame is on medium heat. How can we know that it is done?
You need to press it at least for 5 minutes.
Okay.
Flip it 2 times.
Mm-hmm.
And then hold it and you will know that it has become crisp.
Yes, let me feel it. It's quite hot. See? Like a purple nearly.
Yeah? Yes.
Quite crisp it has become. Now we can remove it and store. And another easier method also, she will show you. See, for those of you who have this roti maker with you, we can show you how to make it in the roti maker. I switched on this roti maker. And another point, those who like the flavor of ghee, in whichever method you make, you can just smear some ghee over it and then keep the kakra for toasting. So you toast the kakra like this. So the ghee side is on top or
yes,
at the bottom?
The ghee side is on top.
Ghee side is on top. Cover it.
Close it and then we'll press it slightly. We'll wait for about 6 to 7 seconds and then we'll turn it over.
Okay.
Again press it lightly.
It's very nice. See, this way it is very easy. It's very hot. Be careful,
yes,
Ruby. So it's a very easy method to make. So once you can we roll out all the kakras and keep ready before putting on this?
Yes, yes.
We can do that.
So you can see the difference. If we apply ghee, the color changes. It becomes dark and it is more tastier. Yeah.
Look at the lovely aroma and flavor of ghee, right? And that is without ghee. So that is optional, whichever is your choice. Our crispy and tasty khakras are now done and ready. With 2 cups of flour, we have got about 20 khakras, methi khakras of this size. And it tastes just great with a hot cup of coffee or tea. I'll give a small bit to uncle. You can see how crisp and lovely it is.
Mishka.
Very crispy and lovely, excellent.
Okay. So all thanks to Ruby, who is an expert in so many dishes. This is only one of her dishes which she has shared with us. Ruby, how else can we eat this katra? One is as a side dish with some tea.
Yes, and while traveling, you can also use pickle. You can eat along with pickles.
And some of my subscribers had asked me for some travel foods. I think this is an ideal food for travel. You can make it ahead of time. And once it is cool, I think we can store it in
another. You can store it and you can keep it for approximately about 2 months.
2 months?
Yes, which you can store it for, yes, you can store it for 2 months.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much, Ruby. It's very kind of you to come and show it to all our subscribers. So thank you for watching the video. We'll meet again with another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruby.